Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to use checkboxes, pop-up menus, and other special cell types in Numbers. So I'm using Numbers 3 and we're going to look at all the different types of special cells you can create. Of course you can put a number in a cell, you can put some text in a cell, you can do all sorts of different things with cells, but there are also some special cells that you can select here in Format. If I just go to Format and Cell Type, you can see, for instance, I can select Checkbox as a type of cell. And checkboxes actually have two values, true or false. So I can click here and you can see the actual value is true, or uncheck it and the actual value is false. And you can actually use these in formulas. Like for instance, if I want to use an if formula, if this here, and true or false is a statement by itself. So I can just say if it's true, then say yes. If it's false, then say no. And you can see I get yes there. If I change that check mark, you can see that it changes to respond to that change in value there. And you can perform all sorts of other things in here as well. You can, instead of using this, you can say it's going to be a 5 if it's true and a 7 if it's false. You can see 5 and 7. So you can use checkboxes to give you values by using formulas. But that's not the only special type of cell. We also can choose different things, like for instance star ratings. And star ratings allow you to click here and give a number of stars or something. So this could be useful. And you can see that this actually goes to a numerical value here. So you have, this is a 5 and this is a 1. If I were to do a formula here, equals this times 10, you can see it's a 10, it's a 30, it's a 40. So it's a really convenient way to get a number between 0 and 5. Next we have a slider. So a slider allows you to give a value, and you can see that you have a ton of options over here with the slider. You've got the ability to set the minimum, the maximum, how much to increment it, the number of that's going to show, because it's actually going to show a number in here next to the slider, number of decimal places to use, like that. All sorts of different things that you can do with the slider. And then when you're done, you can actually select a number by sliding up and down. This is great because it limits the range for this cell. And this is just a real number here, so you could perform a calculation based on it. Next we have a stepper. A stepper is like a slider, except you're not going to have a slider there. You just have up and down arrows. So for when you don't need to change the value dramatically, maybe it's a smaller range, like 1 to 7, for instance, or maybe 0 to 70, but in increments of 10, for instance. Now I can, you see I changed that by that. And it's an actual number down there. You can set the format and different things like that as well. And the last special format is the pop-up menu. And with the pop-up menu, it's basically you can populate it with however many items you want. So we can remove these here and add new ones. Let's make that 2. We'll make this one. You can just double click on it to change it. There you go, and you figure out what you start with, and then in here you get to choose it. So if you have a very finite number of things, or you can even do numbers here. So if there's a set amount of numbers, like for instance, you have products at either 10, 15, or $20, you could pick the price out from that, and you can perform calculations on those and it will work. So here's an example where I've put just some normal numerical values in these, and I just have some normal checkboxes here. And what I've done is I've created a formula down here, and you can see I'm using SUMIF, and the range from C2 to C8 as the test value. I'm testing whether or not it's true. And then the range B2 to B8 as the values to add in the sum. So basically it's saying that when one of these is true, take the value from here and add it to the sum. So I get, in this case, 75 plus 80 is 155. If I check this off, I add another 50 to it. Check this off, add another 95 to it. So it's a really easy way to be able to count some values in a sum or average or any calculation that you're doing using checkboxes.